Many people in Los Osos were still without power today after the lights went out during last night's storm. KSBY News reporter Kimberly Cruz has more on the efforts to get the power back on.
I spoke with a PG&E representative earlier today, and she told me that the Los Osos area was one of the biggest areas impacted by power outages during the storm. She told me that as of Thursday morning, there were still 2,500 customers without power.
Wednesday night's rainfall left parts of Los Osos flooded and in the dark.
It was for Washington typical, but for here it was a little unnerving for like my mom and people. We took a drive this morning and there was a lot of people still out.
Amber Files and her family were some of the lucky ones. They didn't lose power, but she said they were ready.
We had our flashlights, our lanterns, we had the games out, the cell phones charged, power packs, all that good stuff.
According to PG&E, there were 49 power outages in total across the Central Coast, affecting thousands of customers. The biggest job awaiting them was this one along South Bay Boulevard. Between the tree branches, you may not notice them at first, but if you look closely, you'll see crew members working to get the branches off the power lines.
So right now we have our crew that are being hoisted by a crane in order to get to some tree branches that are in some lines that are preventing us from re-energizing the line.
Corral says the hazardous conditions Wednesday night forced crews to wait until Thursday to work on these power lines, leaving thousands of residents in Los Osos still without power.
About 7:45 or so, it seems like, it went out, and then we thought it would get turned on pretty quick, but it didn't, and we had flashlights and everything's out.
This power outage started at 6,800 customers. We were able to reconfigure the grid and get circuit power from a different circuit into those customers' homes.
Access to the lines wasn't easy for crews either. Flooding didn't allow them to access the downed lines by ground, and their usual bucket trucks weren't tall enough to reach the lines. Last resort was to bring in this crane. Drivers also experienced some traffic delays with the road being closed down to one lane in order for crews to work.
Power was expected to be restored at 3:30 p.m. Now, at last checked the PG&E outage map around 4 o'clock, and it showed that there were still 50 customers without power. In Los Osos, Kimberly Cruz, KSBY News.